So this video is about the camps that Ainsley, Arthurs, and I facilitated during our 3-month internship with UPLAVA in Peter Maritzburg, South Africa. We ran the camps for 3 weeks during school holidays. So the first week we had the grade 7 girls, the second week we had grade 6 girls, and the third week we had grade 5 girls. We really just wanted these girls to have a safe and fun space to come to during holidays, where they could talk about things that they're going through in their lives or things they're struggling with, and to just feel comfortable and supported in doing so. So we brainstormed some discussion topics that were focused on building self-esteem, leadership, role models, and pupils. These girls, they go through a lot of the same challenges that kids anywhere in the world go through. So issues around insecurities and bullying and feeling uncomfortable in their changing bodies. It's a tough age for anyone, no matter where you are in the world, and so that's why we thought that these topics would be really valuable for these girls.
A huge part of fostering self-esteem is encouraging girls to vocalize the things that they like about themselves. Complimenting ourselves is something we often struggle with, even as adults, so to make it a little bit easier, we started with complimenting others. Each girl wrote their name in the center of a piece of paper, and we all sat in a big circle. The pieces of paper were then passed around the circle, and each person wrote a compliment about that girl. After the papers had gone around the entire circle, they eventually made their way back to the owner. The girls then had time to read over all the positive things that others had to say about them. We found this activity was really helpful in fostering a sense of group togetherness and in helping the girls to understand who they are and who they want to be.
My name is Minenhle. I am 14 years old and I would like to be a doctor when I grow up. I'm caring, kind, and goofy.
Yes.
My name is Esetu. I'm 12 years old. When I grow up, I want to be a doctor to help sick people. Yeah. I'm a kind person, honest, and a caring person.
My name is Andiswa, aka Andy. I'm doing grade 7 in Stanford in South Africa. And when I grow up, I'm 12 years old and I'm turning 13 this year. And when I grow up, I want to be a doctor mostly, but there are 11 other careers and I cannot choose one.
Hello, my name is Thembelihle. I am 12 years old and when I grow up, I want to be a psychologist or an actor. First, goofy, kind, and humble.
Nice. My name is Tananani and my surname is Zungu. I am 14 years old. When I grow up, I want to be a teacher or a social worker. I think that I am kind, lovely, and talkative.
Yeah. Hi, my name is Bulela Zuma. I'm 12 years old. When I grow up, I want to be the astronaut. I'm strong. I'm brave and I'm beautiful.
Yes, you are. Lena Yamachentes
Toxini. We really wanted to make sure that the things we talked about in camp were really relevant and meaningful for these girls. And we also knew that the language barrier might be a little bit more of an issue when we started talking about periods and puberty. So we invited Mantombi, who is a young woman who lived in the same township community. Mantombi spoke Zulu and she also attended the same school that the girls were at now. And so they found it much easier to understand her and really relate to her. So Mantombi came each week and talked about boys and dating and her experiences as a young teenage mom. Teenage pregnancy and safe sex are huge issues in the community, and so we were really happy when we heard how many of the girls found that this day was really the most meaningful and memorable for them.
My weekend camp, I learned a lot from Emily and Ainsley and other girls that we are with. I learned how to respect others, how to be brave, how to talk public.
My favorite part was on Thursday when Matemba came and advised us more about puberty, dating and sexual feelings in our bodies and our hormones during puberty.
We learned a lot about being a girl, role models, puberty and menstruation. Now I know many things.
I learned about puberty, how to stand up for yourself, and how to be confident and to love yourself.
My week at camp was nice because I learned things that I never had before. Most of things that's when your body change, you don't think that you are alone. There are other girls that are changing with you. My favorite part is yesterday because I learned so much and so much at things that I ever had. But this was not good when she told us that he was 16 years old when he got pregnant. Mm. I felt so sorry because maybe me, I could get pregnant too.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. This shit by repetition. My outfit is
hit for a Conor McGregor ticket. To be a girl, this means how to be independent. Not don't spread rumors about others, respect who I am, and don't judge other people.
Being a girl means to be strong, brave, being able to conquer most of the challenges in life, being independent, loving other people, especially your family.
Being a girl means to be independent and to be strong, brave, and yeah.
Girl.
To me, it means being independent, being strong, brave.
To me, it means that I must stand up for myself, brave whenever I have problems coming through my way, and I must talk to someone I trust.
Girls to think about who their role models were and what it was about them that they admired. This got them thinking about the type of person that they want to be and also about what qualities are really important in a person. We then asked the girls to think about who they might be role models for, such as younger students in the school or younger siblings. Thinking about themselves as a role model really encouraged the girls to be the best version of themselves.
I will tell them that during puberty, everything they're going through is normal. It happens to lots of girls. It's just a girl thing.
Yeah.
The younger people, I would say that they must stay away from phones, study more, and they must abstain, and they must study more to grow up and fill up their dreams, fulfill their dreams. And they must be strong, brave, confident, independent.
Be happy with your body and do not think that you are alone when you are changing. You are just like us. And do not think that when you are a girl, maybe the bodies of the girls do not change, not like the same. So don't think that you are just different between us.
Yeah.
They must be themselves and believe to themselves and do their interest. Yes.
At the end of the week, we gave each girl a gift bag with feminine hygiene products, soap, deodorant, a pair of underwear, and some treats. A lot of these girls don't have access to feminine hygiene products, and we had spent a lot of time throughout the week talking about what to do when you get your period and how to manage the changes that our bodies go through during puberty. I really didn't expect a group of preteens to be so excited about receiving a pair of underwear.
I'm giving, they taking, tripping, I'm falling, tell me I'm nothing.